Avete presente tutti quegli appassionati di motori in Italia che credono convintamente come le vere auto siano senza elettronica e debbano avere quattro ruote, un cambio manuale e uno sterzo? Sto ancora aspettando il momento in cui dichiareranno che le vere auto si mettono in moto a manovella, come inizio Novecento. Vorrei proprio vederli a farlo. E i fari riempiti a olio combustibile dove li mettiamo? Che brutte le luci che usano la batteria di sistema, troppo moderne. Non sono sufficientemente difficili e scomode da usare per far parte di una vera auto. Bene, se avete inquadrato il tema, l'auto di cui faccio l'anteprima oggi per loro è l'Anticristo. Ha la guida autonoma di livello 4, cioè senza la necessità dell'intervento e dell'attenzione umana, nei paesi in cui è permessa la normativa. Ha un sensore LiDAR per mappare la forma e la distanza di tutti gli oggetti davanti a lei e altri 32 tra telecamere e radar per quelli intorno. È full electric, ma risolve strutturalmente la maggiore critica su questo tipo di alimentazione, in quanto la batteria si può cambiare in meno di 5 minuti con una già carica durante lunghi viaggi. Oppure con una più grande da caricare tramite presa come le altre elettriche, fino a 140 kW di potenza. Inoltre, la predispone a supportarne una migliore o più capiente man mano che la tecnologia avanza, grazie alle stazioni di scambio che sono già 30 in Europa e più di 1100 in Cina, con accordi in corso tra vari brand per renderlo uno standard. NIO ET7 è un'auto di 5,10 m, la seconda più grande fatta da NIO, tecnologicamente al di sopra della sua categoria, tra cui Tesla Model S, BMW Serie 5, Mercedes EQS e molte altre. Con un prezzo di partenza di 82.000 € per una batteria da 75 kWh e un range massimo di 1.000 km con quella da 150 kWh. La trazione è integrale con 644 cavalli complessivi e 850 Nm di coppia, per uno 0-100 di 3,8 secondi su un'auto da oltre 2.300 kg, dotata comunque di ottima maneggevolezza e silenziosità, grazie alle sospensioni ad aria e ai freni Brembo. Gli interni contano sedili in pelle riscaldati, ventilati e massaggiati, sia davanti che dietro, un assistente virtuale chiamata Nomi che riconosce sia lo stato di attenzione e sonnolenza che le vostre richieste vocali, con un processing avanzato. Ha il tetto in vetro, schermato da raggi solari, un monitor al posteriore come la nuova Model 3 di Tesla, camere 360 con vista 3D e dashcam in 4K personalizzabile. Il coefficiente aerodinamico è di 0,21 grazie alla forma sinuosa e alle maniglie motorizzate a scomparsa, che permettono anche la chiusura automatica delle portiere quando le socchiudete per il massimo silenzio. E la loro filosofia è farsi tutto in casa, a parte le batterie. Un po' come Tesla che ne ha giovato per costi di produzione e qualità. Insomma, sembra promettere una rivoluzione nell'intero mercato automotive, con tecnologie che verranno ereditate e rese standard sui futuri modelli economici. Vi lascio il test drive in inglese, con sottotitoli attivabili dal bottone CC in basso a destra. Si è restati su Carwai. Alla prossima!
This way of electrifying everything, also the controls, is great. You have the customizable seat also underneath, and you have memories, I think. I mean, you can record all the
Yeah,
positions.
of course. And the nice thing about that is this is Nomi, and Nomi
Yeah,
will recognize you when you enter the car, and she
great.
will automatically put your car in the correct position.
Okay, hi Nomi.
Hello. Sorry.
Is the steering wheel correct?
Maybe
You can just like
yeah,
this.
with this.
Yep.
This is for up and down. This is down enough. This is
That's it.
okay. Do you use cameras or radar to create this effect?
None of the above. LiDAR.
LiDAR, great, great.
Yeah.
It's a great solution that Tesla is not using,
Yep. No,
obviously.
you can go right. Yeah. No, it's just.
It's fine. Okay.
Yeah.
Let's do like this. Wow, I like the steering wheel. I like more than Zeekr, but I don't say it too much loud. I didn't see that in this. Wow, the materials are not that expensive,
And
but
Zeekr.
premium. Yeah, than Zeekr, but this is better as a driving experience.
Yes, but to be honest, this car is also a lot more expensive than the Zeekr.
Yeah,
But
sure.
for this car, you also have 650 horsepower, air suspension, front and
Yeah.
back. So.
The expensive part is the how is it? The main part.
Yeah, but
There is the materials and the
also the
finish.
LiDAR is quite expensive.
Sure.
Yeah. This car has 33 cameras and sensors.
Wow, it's the part that's expensive
Yeah,
also, the LiDAR.
and it also processes 8 GB of data every second.
What's this button
for the driving modes?
Okay, driving modes.
I think I didn't. So, comfort, if you, for instance, go to Sport Plus where you have the.
Okay, let's try and then the Sport Plus.
And then you will feel the car will go down now. As you see, it goes down. Because air suspension goes down, suspension gets stiffer. The wheel
gets
exactly
also,
and you get the full power.
Okay, let's try this. What about ACC, adaptive cruise control?
Yeah, it's on now. You can use it with that button.
Okay, it's just a button, and then you set the speed.
Yeah, exactly. But now at this moment, it's not an ACC, but it's in lane change mode. So that's basically the pilot.
Oh wow. I would try that, but I really want to drive the car today. I can feel the difference in the pedal, in the acceleration pedal.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's quite a big difference.
Wow, it's far, far better than even the Tesla Model 3, obviously. That is my benchmark usually.
Mm-hmm.
And is this four-wheel driving?
Yeah.
Driving?
NIO as a brand always only offers four-wheel driving.
Great. Two motors, one on the front, one on the back.
We have one magnet motor and one induction motor.
Okay, great.
Magnet, of course, for the good range.
Yeah.
And the induction motor for the high power.
Wow, it's automatically adapting the cameras when it sees the obstacles.
Yeah, when something's too close.
Great. What about data processing? In Europe, there is a lot of talking about sending data and video data and biometric data around the world.
Yeah.
How do you think about? How do you treat data?
Yeah, so we are fully GDPR compliant.
Okay.
And the GDPR prescribes that data cannot leave Europe.
Yeah,
so
sure.
Our data servers are in Germany.
Yeah.
So, and what I always find interesting is that we are completely GDPR compliant. And I think as a Chinese company, we have to be as well.
Sure.
And I always get the question from customers from
lots of complaint now.
Exactly. Yeah, but the thing is, Tesla has never been GDPR compliant. All the data goes to America, maybe even goes to other parts of the world.
Yeah,
nobody
America's
complains about that, but
China.
Because we are, and to be honest, our design is in Germany. So lots of the things about Nomi are designed in Germany. Our servers are in Germany, so you could almost say that Nomi is a German product.
Yeah. Yeah, sure.
We are completely GDPR compliant. So if anyone needs any data about that, we can also share it.
Yeah, sure.
So yeah, no problem.
Let's talk about auto braking mode. Is there any one pedal mode?
No, not yet. No. So we have a 4G network, and every update is
okay. Sorry, I had
no problem. Every update is downloaded automatically.
Yeah.
So you don't need Wi-Fi or anything. Okay. Quite recently, we had a big update when we went from OS 1.0 to 2.0.
Great.
And we basically redid everything of which we thought.
That's a big milestone, I think.
Yeah.
And what about the service?
Once every 36 months or 200,000 kilometers.
Okay, great. And the connection service is by subscription or is in the car? The 4G connection
is in. It's included with the car.
Okay, it's included with car. Great.
Yeah, so you don't have to pay extra.
Great. Okay, yeah, for the city, the sport mode probably is too stiff, mm-hmm. but obviously I like it. And I can feel the wheel is really direct. The seat is the best I've tried between the one in this event.
Yeah, that's good to hear.
Yes.
Also, we are already driving level 4 autonomously in China.
Yeah.
So the car can do it.
Yeah, sure. Obviously, the legislation can't.
Yeah. In Europe, we can't. But the car is ready for it. So once we get the legislation in Europe to do it, this car, this specific car, will also be able to do it.
Sure. What's your plan in exporting to Italy, in coming to Italy, I mean?
We are working on opening Italy.
Yeah.
But I can't at the moment say anything about when or where.
Great. What's the price of this car?
It's including battery, starting at 83,000 euros.
Great. Longest range one? Do you have just
580.
One?
But we do have, because we have the, of course, we have the battery swapping system.
Sure, but just in Germany and in
no,
which
we have
country?
We have in Norway, Sweden, Denmark, Germany, sure. Netherlands.
Okay, great.
China, of course.
China, of course. I will not go to China just to swap the battery, though.
No.
Is the battery on subscription? I mean, you can. My idea when I've seen you the first time is, wow, you can go around the city with the light battery with more efficiency and then swap it for the longest range one when you need it.
Exactly.
Is this possible as a subscription service? How it does happen?
Yeah, so in case of when you go for the 75 kilowatt battery,
yeah,
the car costs 83.
Yeah,
but the battery itself costs 12,000 euros.
Sure.
So
you don't buy it usually.
You pay only 71,000 euros, sure, for the car, and then you pay a monthly fee for the battery.
Okay.
And once you will upgrade the battery,
yeah,
you will pay a higher amount,
yeah,
for that week or day or month.
Okay, you can also day basis. You can also do day basis.
So we are working on that right now, also on the price point and those kind of things. So we hope to have more information about the cost, the possibilities, the number of days, number of time, those kind of things, beginning of next year.
Okay, great, thank you.
It's much fun.
I really
it feels really stable, right?
Yeah, it doesn't slip even if the street is slippery and it rains constantly.
Yeah.
And
this is the only car I feel like my grandma could do 0 to 100 in 3 seconds in.
What about the entertainment system? I feel it rapid. And you can also control the climate.
Yep.
Differently, left and right.
Yep.
Not front and back, I think.
Also back. Yeah.
Also back.
Yeah.
So you can split from the back. Okay.
Yeah.
This is just for the front.
Yep.
Okay. You have apps.
We are working on a third party app store where we can add all apps.
Great. Will the app be tested by you before? Because obviously, for a security reason, it's not that easy. Do you have the dash cam, the recording stuff? Is it automated or is it like. Okay, is it always automated? Because if you think about, you could like register 3, 5, 10 minutes always round.
Yeah,
recording only the crash. I mean, like there is a crash, you register the 10 last minutes. Is it possible in your car instead of always recording?
Yeah.
Okay.
It automatically saves
loop videos.
Yeah,
like
loop
that.
Videos, but also emergencies.
Okay,
so
great.
Heartbreaking.
So you're ready.
Yeah.
Okay, great.
And you can also adjust what you want to do, just braking or. Emergencies or heartbreaking or always.
Okay. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Thank you for your information.
Perfect.